Pumpkin seed oil has become very popular in the world of hair growth and regrowth. Question is, does it actually work? Let's look at the proof and before and after pictures of people who tried this natural remedy. So let's begin by looking at the very first clinical trial on pumpkin seed and hair regrowth. This study comes out in 2014. 76 men with male pattern baldness are given 400 milligrams of pumpkin seed oil supplements or a placebo for 6 months. After the study, the researchers report that the men using pumpkin seed oil, they had a 40% increase in the number of hairs counted on their scalps. Pretty impressive, and this was significantly better than the 10% increase in hair growth count they saw in those who took a placebo. Now that all sounds great, but what about before and after pictures? Fortunately, they do show us pictures in this study. Let's take a look at them now. Here's a before and after picture of one of the guys in this study, and no doubt about it, there is a significant difference in hair growth and coverage of hair on the scalp. Here's another picture of a different guy in this study where the results are not as dramatic as the first picture I showed you. However, we do see significantly more hair growth from pumpkin seed oil. And here is yet another picture of a different guy in this study, which is showing dramatic improvement of hair growth from pumpkin seed oil after 6 months of use. And from looking at these pictures, it also seems to show that pumpkin seed oil appears to be improving the thickness of the hair as well. However, they point out in this study that that's not actually happening. Nonetheless, these before and after pictures are very dramatic. And then we have this paper, which came out 5 years later in 2019, which purports to show pumpkin seed oil also regrowing hair in mice. In 2020, we have another investigation also showing pumpkin seed oil appears to work. However, again, this is a mouse study, so I'm not even going to talk about it anymore. Let's move on to the next investigation, which thankfully is a human study. This one came out in 2021. What's interesting about this paper is they are comparing pumpkin seed oil effectiveness to minoxidil. 60 women in their 30s who are dealing with hair loss are given either pumpkin seed oil or a 5% solution of minoxidil. They are told to use both of these solutions, or either of these solutions, once per day. So once per day, they're using pumpkin seed oil, and then another group is using once per day a 5% solution of minoxidil. Okay, so proof is in the pudding. Let's look at the before and after pictures. Here we have one woman in this study who was suffering from hair loss for 1 year. On the left, we see her before using pumpkin seed oil, and on the right, we see the same woman 3 months later. I see a difference in hair regrowth with this solution, but the question is, do you? Now let's compare her to another woman who used minoxidil for 3 months. Here's another woman in this investigation who used minoxidil, and there is a dramatic improvement in hair regrowth from using minoxidil. And looking at these pictures side by side, it does appear to me that minoxidil is superior to pumpkin seed oil for regrowing hair. And they actually do say that basically in the study by saying that minoxidil is still the gold standard. Now, a couple problems with this study I thought were, A, they only had these people doing the solutions once per day, which I thought was odd because if you look at the directions for minoxidil, it usually calls for using it twice per day. Another issue I have with this paper is they had 60 people in this study, and yet they're only showing us a picture of one person who used pumpkin seed oil and one person who used minoxidil. Nevertheless, there does appear to be something going on with pumpkin seed oil. And the $64,000 question is, how does pumpkin seed oil regrow hair? And the speculation right now is that various healthy oils in the pumpkin seed oil appear to be inhibiting an enzyme called 5-alpha reductase. Now, 5-alpha reductase is the enzyme that converts testosterone into DHT, dihydrotestosterone. And DHT is implicated in hair loss. It's also interesting that pumpkin seed oil also contains a little bit of beta-cytosterol, which also inhibits 5-alpha reductase as well. And beta-cytosterol is also found in some expensive hair regrowth supplements. Now, all that said, one thing I did notice when I read these investigations is that the researchers didn't actually measure before and after DHT levels, which to me says we need more study to know if that's the way it really does work.